Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, I'm Zhong. Today I'm going to continue the artwork by add the tree, then put on the color, lighting, and set up the camera to finish the scene. So without further ado, let's get started. So first, before we put on the color to the building, I actually need to make some minor correction to our 3D element. So press Shift B and zoom into our 3D element. Select our roof corner. Press Tab to go into Edit Mode. Press 3 to switch the selection mode to the face select, or you can press here. Then select the faces and delete it. Press Tab again to exit the Edit Mode. Then next, we need to cover the ugly hole on the roof. Go back to our 3D element. Select the roof. Press Tab to go into Edit Mode. Press 1 to switch the selection mode to the vertices select, or you can press here. Select the vertices and press F to fill it. Press Tab again to exit the edit mode. Then we check our roof again. And it looks a lot better now. Okay, next, we can start to put on the color to the building. So go to our 3D element again. Press numpad 1 to see the front view. So let's start with our ground floor element. Select it and press Tab to go into edit mode. Press 3 to switch the selection mode to the face select, or you can press here. Close the geometry node editor, we don't need it for now. Change the viewport shading to material preview mode. Then press A to select all faces. Go to the material properties tab, then press new to assign a new material. Then change the base color to any color you like. Then press alternate G to switch to X-ray mode and select two of the row on the top. Then press plus button here to add a new material. Press new and click assign to assign it. And now select the door. Then assign the white color onto it. Select this material and click assign. Select two of the faces here. And I'm going to assign black color onto it. Again, press the plus button and then press new. Then I want to add some color to the floor as well. Assign white color onto it. You can put whatever color you want, don't have to follow me. Then I want to add a color to the frame as well. Press Ctrl numpad 3 to see the side view. And then select it. Deselect these faces. And assign a white color onto it. Then press Tab again to exit the edit mode. And next, I'm going to do the same step for the rest of the 3D element, so you can do it yourself. Thank you. Okay, now we have done everything. And next, I actually want to mix two different types of window for second floor or above. So to do this, go back to select our building. Split the screen and go to Geometry Node Editor. Let's scroll to our point instance node for the windows. This is our windows. I think previously I forgot to include this into the modifier properties. Select the node and click collection and tick the whole collection in the 3D viewport. Go back to our 3D element. Select two of the items here and press M to add it into a new collection. Name it windows. Click OK. Then now go back to our geometry node editor. In the collection column, select windows. And then we can connect the collection to the group input here. Connect it to the group input in the empty dot here. Then go to group tab, select the collection and name it windows. And then we actually can connect the seed value to the group input as well. Again, go to group tab, select the seed and name it randomize windows. You can put whatever name you want, as long as you know what it is. So next time when we need to make the changes, we can straight away go to modifier properties and do it. And then we need to do the same thing for the another side of wall facing to x-axis. So scroll it below, select this, click collection, untick the whole collection and select windows. Then connect the collection to the windows and connect the seed to the randomized windows. And now we have done the building. Okay, next, I want to add low poly 3 to our scene. So to do it, in the 3D viewport, press numpad 7 to see the top view and move the building to put at the center. Select the floor, press shift D to duplicate the floor. Then press tab to go into edit mode, press I for insert faces. Then delete the faces in the middle. Press tab to exit the edit mode and move it lower. And remember to press Ctrl A to apply the scale. Then now we can start to add our low poly tree. Press Shift A and add a cube. Then press numpad slash to focus the object. Then scale the cube smaller and make it taller. And then press Ctrl A and apply the scale. And then press Shift A again and add another cube. Press tab to go into edit mode, select the faces on top of the cube and make it smaller. Then press tab again to exit the edit mode. Then go to modifier properties and add a subdivision surface. Increase the level viewport to 3, then scale it bigger. Then apply the subdivision surface. Then right click the 3 and apply shade smooth onto it. And then now we need to add a color onto the leaf. So go to the material properties, press new, then change the base color to orange color. And next, select the trunk and we need to add white color onto it. Okay, now select the trunk and the leaf, press Ctrl J to join it together, and then press numpad slash again to unfocus the object, then scale the tree smaller and put it somewhere beside the building. But of course you can put anywhere you want, but I'm going to put it beside the building. Then select the plane we duplicate just now and go to the geometry node editor. Press new to apply geometry node to the plane. Press shift A and add a point distribute node. And then press shift A again and add a point instance node. In the object column, use the eyedropper to select our low poly tree. Currently the tree is too big, we need to make it smaller. So to do it, press shift A again and add a attribute randomized node. In the attribute column, tap scale. Then change the max value to 0.1. You can experiment with other value as well. It depends on how big you want the tree to be. Then you can play with the seed as well. I think I want to decrease the point density as well. Currently, there's too much tree in the scene. And not sure if you guys noticed, some of the tree is currently floating in the air and is supposed to stick on the floor. So to fix this issue, go back to our main tree. Here, press tab to go into edit mode, press alternate G and select the vertices at the bottom, press shift S and select cursor to selected. Press tab again, go to object and set the origin to 3D cursor. And now we can move our tree to stick on the floor. Okay, next we need to take our floor and make it bigger to cover the entire scene. Then go to material properties tab and add a new material. Change the base color to yellow color. And then press shift A again and add a camera. And then press Ctrl Alternate 0 to move the camera to match the current 3D viewport. Then go to the camera properties tab and change the focal length to 120mm. So it will look more like an isometric view. Then press Shift Tilt to adjust the camera until the angle you want. I think we can try to decrease the width and length of the building. Then we are able to make it close up a little bit. Then move our main tree to put it beside the building. Okay, next I want to add a root around the building. So to do it, press numpad 7 to see the top view. Press shift A and add a plane. Move it to the center. Press S to make it bigger. Then press G and Z to make it higher. Then press tab to go into edit mode. Press I for inset faces. Then delete the faces in the center. Then press 3 to switch the select mode to the face select, or you can press here. Then press A to select all faces and press E to extrude it. We need to make it slightly thicker. And now I want to make it rounded edge. So in order to do it, press 2 to switch the select mode to edge. Then select one of the edge in the corner. Then press shift G and select length. That means Blender will automatically select all the similar length. Then press Ctrl B to bevel it. Change the segment to 6 and then press tab again to exit the edit mode. Make it slightly lower until it touches the floor, and maybe we can scale it smaller as well. And now go to material properties tab and add a new material. Change the base color to gray color maybe. And then we can start to add lighting to the scene. Go to render properties tab, change the render engine to cycles, then change the device to GPU compute, then change the viewport shading to render preview, then go to world properties tab in the color section, select sky texture. I think we can disable the viewport wireframe already since we don't need it anymore. Change the sun size to 10. The larger the value, the softer shadow we will get. Change the sun intensity to 0.1. Change the sun elevation to 20 maybe. Change the strength to 0.6. You don't have to follow me exactly, you can experiment with this value to get the lighting you want. Maybe we can try to reduce the reflection of the floor. Go to material properties tab and increase the roughness. And now we done it. So if you like my video, please subscribe and see you next week. Bye.